السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه وولاه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد, for those who are familiar with the Quran, I know that this is the strangest قراءة so far. So this is the قراءة of the six قارئ. You know, we have the famous seven قراءات and then the three completing ones. So total 10, alhamdulillah. So we did al-Imam Nafi' for 3 days, and then we did al-Imam Ibn Kathir for 3 days, Abi Amr al-Basri from Basra for 3 days, Ibn Amr al-Dimashqi from Damascus for 3 days, and Asim, the one famous, Shu'ba and Hafs, and we did finish yesterday. Those are 5. And the number 6, al-Imam Hamza Ibn Habib al-Zayyat, one of the great Imams who recited on those who recited in Tabi'een and the Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Imam Hamza is famous with Imala. So any alif at the end, like hawa, fastawa, this alif is will become like a ya with Imala. وَالنَّجْمِ إِذَا هَوِي مَا ضَلَّ صَاحِبُكُمْ وَمَا غَوِي وَالضُّحِي وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا سَجِي, like that. Imala. Except if the alif is originated from waw. That's why you noticed when I say ثُمَّ دَنَا, I did not say ثُمَّ دَنِي, right? ثُمَّ دَنَا فَتَدَلِّي. So دَنَا because مِنَ الدُّنُو, دَنَا يَدْنُو. So this cannot be imala. Right, so it's lots of grammar and Arabic and all of that. It's very precise, mashallah. Also, Imam Hamza, there are many words. Kabair becomes like Kabir al-Ithmi. He stops before the Hamza, al-Ard, al-Ithm, al-Untha, except if you're stopping at it. That's why I told you it's the hardest qira'ah, right? If you join, then you do, you know, wal unthi, and then you continue. But if you stop, you say wal unthi, like this. So he make naql if you stop. So this is khalaf an Hamza. Inshallah, tomorrow khalad, a little bit easier, but it is the same thing, inshallah. So just give you a taste. I want you, inshallah, to go to Google, go to YouTube, right? YouTube, and put that, you know, say, recitation of Khalaf an Hamza, from Hamza. And you will see, mashallah, very famous, prominent sheikhs having the whole Quran with that riwayah, you know, the whole Quran, 20 different ways, mashallah, it is very famous. And King Fahd Complex now printing the Quran in all different qira'at. It is available there, you know, there are masahif in all of them. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Tonight, I wanted to talk to you about المحبة والأخوة في الله. You know, love and brotherhood in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is a hadith in Sahih. There is a hadith in Sahih Muslim. The hadith in Sahih Muslim that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that a man went and visited his brother in another town. He's from a town, and he went through lots of trouble to visit his brother, not biological brother, but brother in faith, brother in iman, in another town. فَأَرْصَدَ اللَّهُ لَهُ عَلَى مَدْرَجَتِهِ مَلَكَ. Before, the angels used to come and talk to people. People talk to angels, and angels talk to people, and they identify themselves that they are angels, that they are from Allah Azza wa Jal. So Allah Azza wa Jal make an angel on his path, stopped him. That's the Prophet saying that, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Qala, you know, ayna turid? Where are you going? Qala, uridu akhan li fi hadhihi al-qariya. I'm going to visit my brother in that town. Qala, hal laka alayhi min ni'matin? Hal laka alayhi min ni'ma? Yani, is there anything that he owes you that you're going, yani, to get? Qala, la. Ghayra anni ahbabtuhu fi Allahi azza wa jal. I'm just going because I love him for the sake of Allah. That's all. And all this trouble, I'm going to go see my brother because I love him for the sake of Allah. So the angel told him, فَإِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكَ. I am the messenger of Allah to you. أَنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ أَحَبَّكَ كَمَا أَحْبَبْتَهُ فِيهِ. That Allah tells you truly, he loves you like you love your brother for his sake. You see, my brother? That's why when somebody loves someone, he should tell him, I love you, ya akhi. sisters. When you love a sister, tell her, I love you, sister, but not brother and sister, okay? This is yani brothers only, sisters only, exclusive, right? Unless you tell your wife or your sister, you know, this biological sister is another story. But don't go tell each other, I love you today, right? Okay, so for the sake of Allah. So if you love someone, you tell them, I love you for Allah's sake. And it has to be in the halal way, of course. I love you for Allah's sake. What is the reply? أحبك الذي أحببتني فيه. May Allah loves you like you love me for His sake. So that's a hadith. Also, you know the hadith of the seven people who are under the shade of Allah, right? You know this hadith? There is a hadith. Seven categories. One of them is what? Two people, they love each other for sake of Allah. When they gather for sake of Allah. When they depart for the sake of Allah. Now, a third hadith, and I'll finish inshallah. Inna Allah yaqulu yawm al-qiyamah. Allah Azza wa Jal yawm al-qiyamah will call. Will make a call himself subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is that? Aina al-mutahabbuna bi jalali. Where are those who love each other for me, for my sake? اليوم today أظلهم في ظلي يوم لا ظل إلا ظلي. Today I'm going to shade them in my shade when there is no shade except mine. Allah Azza wa Jalla will call those who love each other for His sake. Imagine in that day you are in the shade of Allah. Where are you going to go after that? And if Allah put you in His shade while He's accounting everybody else, where are you going to go? Of course, of course. So loving each other is a faster highway to, but it has to be sincere. So inshallah, in the next couple of days we will talk about few things. I will mention one today only among the characteristic of those whom you should love for Allah's sake, not anybody, not anybody. First one, that they have to be religious and they have to be pious. You cannot love someone for the sake of Allah while they are disobeying Allah. How you love someone who disobeys Allah? So the first condition to love someone to get to Jannah, to get to the shade of Allah, they have to be among the people who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in their tongue, the way they talk, the way they see, the way they walk, the way they behave. So bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, tonight we make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All of us, we want to be those. Not to be looking for someone. Before you look for someone who is pious and righteous, you first. And because everybody will be looking for you too. So sometimes you say, oh, I'm not good, let me look for someone good. No, no, no. We want you to be good. We want you to be the one who's good. I want to find you good to be my brother for the sake of Allah and the sister for the sake of Allah. May Allah make us all brothers and sisters in His cause. وَإِنِّي وَاللَّهِ أُحِبُّكُمْ جَمِيعًا فِي اللَّهِ. I love you all for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَجَزَاكُمُ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا. After, inshallah.